बहुत ही महत्वपूर्ण दिन है हमारे कैलाश मानसरोवर यात्रा 2019 के इस आयोजन में। आज पहला बैच डिपू लेक के द्वारा प्रस्थान करेगा यात्रा के लिए। हमने जो प्रयास किए हैं अभी तक इस यात्रा के लिए इस साल, मैं समझता हूँ कि आज उसका एक परिणाम दिवस है। एंड वी आर वेरी हैप्पी टू हैव अमिडस्ट अस द एक्सटर्नल अफेयर्स मिनिस्टर डॉक्टर एस जयशंकर। He will preside over the commencement ceremony of this year's yatra. I would now like to invite Dr. Jaishankar to make his remarks to you and also announce the commencement of the yatra.
Namaskar. मुझे आपका विदेश मंत्रालय में स्वागत करने पर बहुत प्रसन्नता है। आज हम कैलाश मानसरोवर यात्रा 2019 का शुरुआत करते हैं। ये यात्रा विदेश मंत्रालय द्वारा आयोजित एक बहुत ही महत्वपूर्ण आयोजन है। द मिनिस्ट्री ऑफ एक्सटर्नल अफेयर्स फील्स वेरी प्रिविलेज्ड टू बी पार्ट ऑफ दिस इनिशिएटिव फॉर फैसिलिटेटिंग कैलाश मानसरोवर यात्रा। दिस हैज बीन अ यात्रा व्हिच हैज स्टार्टेड इन रीसेंट टाइम्स फ्रॉम 1981 एंड ओवर द ईयर्स the interest in this pilgrimage has increased very significantly. I would like to share with you a personal experience which I myself had in 2012. I had the privilege of visiting Mount Kailash, not in the way in which you are all going to do through the Lake of Nepal. I actually was ambassador in China at that time and I went from Lhasa. In many ways, my journey was very much easier than what all of you are going to do. But I want to just tell you something, that whatever is in your mind about what you will see, what, you know, the biggest thing in your imagination, when you actually reach there, what you will see is something far, far beyond anything you can. If I were to look back and think of all the moments of my life which I will really remember, for me, seeing Mount Kailash and Lake Mansarovar would be one of them. So you are at the juncture of something very special, very holy. And no words that I can say, you have to see it, you have to be there and see it to experience it. But having said that, I want to share with you what has been the ministry's contribution to this pilgrimage. We started in 1981 with very small batches. It was a much more difficult at that time. And today 18 batches of 60 yatris each performed this yatra along the old Lipu Lake route which all of you are going to take. And 10 batches of 48 yatris will do it along the Nathula route which opened in 2015. This year we received almost 3,000 applications, completed applications for the yatra. And this is, I think, something which makes me very happy. It shows that more and more people in this country want to go to Mount Kailash. I think that in itself is something which gives us great satisfaction. What we have done recently is that the fully motorable Nathula Road has been opened for the yatra. So lot of the elderly people who are not able to do what you will all be doing, they will find a much easier route to also go to Mount Kailash. We have also decided to include two liaison officers per batch, to assist the yatris more effectively. And as part of our efforts to improve the yatra experience, we have decided to include liaison officers who have been there before so that, because it is not an easy yatra, that is something I think all of you know, and I think to have experienced people with you will be very, very useful. The yatra is considered one of the most difficult pilgrimages in the world, but I'm sure that you all know that it passes through what is both difficult territory but also beautiful territory. And while we will obviously try to make this as smooth an experience as possible, I think your cooperation and your understanding during the yatra is also important. The liaison officers and the government authorities involved in the conduct of the yatra have been asked to accord the highest priority to the safety and security of the yatra. It is important that you all diligently follow the safety advice. I really stress this, that you must follow the safety advice and instructions of the liaison officers, so that there is no personal safety issue which arises for any of the yatris. The yatris, not just you, but I think the subsequent batches also, you are all from different parts of India. I think it's also perhaps right for me to mention that you are all collectively embarked on a yatra. You must be together as a very cohesive group. And particularly because there are challenging conditions. So I think your internal solidarity, how you bond with each other, I think that is also something which I would emphasize very strongly. Let me take this opportunity to record our appreciation for the support and cooperation that we have received from many other ministries and agencies of the Government of India, and particularly for the state governments of Uttarakhand, Sikkim and Delhi in the successful organization of this yatra. I would also like to recognize the support extended by the Government of the People's Republic of China in organizing the yatra, which is an important step towards promoting people-to-people exchanges and strengthening friendship and understanding between our two countries. All those who have been selected for the yatra are really blessed to be participating in this divine expedition. It is a call from Lord Shiva, and this privilege of divine blessing has been accorded to you. We wish you a very safe journey and a truly fulfilling spiritual experience. With these words, I announce the commencement of Kailash Mansarovar Yatra 2022.